Hi there, this is Saloni, an IELTS trainer and a motivational speaker once again in front of you from Sacred English Academy. This video is for the IELTS students, especially for the speaking module. Okay, so imagine tomorrow is your IELTS speaking test and you are prepared for the part 1, part 2 and part 3. But what about part 0? Yes, part 0, that means introduction part. Are you ready for that? Do you know what is included in the part 0? Part 0 includes the introduction of the examiner and the few questions that the examiner asks to the examinee, that means to the student. So today I'm going to discuss with you part 0. So let's begin. Before starting with the video, I want to say one thing, that part 0 is very important. Part 0 is something when you're going to face the examiner for the first time, you have to stay confident at that time, because if you're confident in answering the part 0 questions, that means there are chances that you can also overcome your fear throughout your other parts of the speaking module. But if you're not confident, if you're feeling nervous in the part 0, there are also some chances that you can be nervous in the other parts as well. So stay confident and listen to me very carefully that what I'm going to say, how the examiner will start the speaking, what question, or how the examiner will introduce himself or herself in the beginning. So listen very, very carefully. And now I'm going to start. So when you go or when you enter the room for the speaking module, the first thing what the examiner say is, look at the board. E is used for the examiner and S is used for the student. We can even say examinee, but I have changed the word because I want you to understand much better. E for the examiner, S for the student. So what the examiner say when you enter the room, the first thing that examiner says is, good afternoon, my name is Kate. It depends upon the time. If it is morning, the examiner will say good morning. If it is evening, the examiner will say good evening. So it will change according to the time. And even the name will change. Here it is written, good afternoon, my name's Kate. After wishing, the examiner will ask you the first question, and that is, what is your name? The examiner is interested to know your name, or he or she can ask in other words also by saying, tell me your full name. If he asks in this manner, tell me your full name, or if he asks in another manner, what is your name, that means you have to speak your name. This is the first question that the examiner asks you when you enter or when you sit for the speaking module of IELTS. So how you have to answer? Let's see. S is for the student. Now how the student has to answer this question, I'm going to tell you. So the student can say, my name's Johnny Smith. Johnny Smith is the name of the student. You can put your name. You can say, my name's John. My name's Peter, or anything, Peter Smith. But one thing you have to very clear here is names. I haven't written my name is. I have written my names. My name's Johnny Smith. It means I am using contraction here. Contraction means I am not saying the words in a complete line that my name is Johnny Smith. I am saying my name's Johnny Smith. So the reason of using names is contraction, and contraction shows that you have full control over the language and you know how to contract the things. It always have a positive impression on the examiner. So make sure that you also answer to this question in the same manner by using names, not name is. The full line is, my name's Johnny Smith. Whenever you speak your name, Johnny Smith, you have to keep into your mind that you have to speak your name very clearly. It shouldn't be in a very speed, my name is Johnny Smith. No. You have to say very calmly, my name's Johnny Smith. My name's John, whatever it is. My name's, whatever your name is, say very calmly so that the examiner could listen to it clearly, because it's your name and it has its own importance. So be very careful at this time. The examiner can ask you the second question in this manner, what can I call you? Or in other words, how could I address you? So this question means the examiner is asking you that what he should call to you. And in the second question, he's also asking the same thing, but the word address is being used. Address doesn't mean that the examiner is interested to know your address. Actually, he's asking that how should he call you. So the first question, what can I call you? Or how could I address you, have actually same meaning. The examiner is asking about how should he call you. But some students get perplexed or confused that address means something related to address. It is not address, I'm repeating, it is your name, what the examiner should call you by. So you can answer in this manner, you can call me Johnny. Or you can say, please call me Johnny. There are some students I have seen, they always extend this answer. But you don't have to extend the answer. Stick to the question, just answer in a single line, please call me Johnny. But the students often say, different people call me in different manner. My friend has different name for me. My family has different name for me. Like my friends call me John. My mom, dad call me Johnny. So you can call me in any name. No, this is not the way to answer. Stick to the question, say directly, please call me Johnny, or you can call me Johnny. The next question is, where are you from? So the examiner is asking, where are you from, where you come from? That means you belong to which city or which region. The examiner is asking you by saying these lines. Where are you from or where you come from? So what you have to answer is, I come from Amritsar. You can say anything. I come from Patiala. I come from Jalandhar. I come from Delhi. It could be anything according to your place of living. And you can answer in other words also, I'm from Amritsar, which is in the northern part of India. You can see I have used the contraction here. I'm from Amritsar. I'm from Amritsar means contraction. Contraction means you have a good hold over the language and you know how to contract the things. So if you say in this manner, you can say I'm from Amritsar, which is in the northern part of India. One more thing, don't elaborate this answer very much. Just answer this question in two or three lines. And very essential thing that I would like to highlight here is, there are some students who always recommend the examiner that it's a very good place, you must visit this place. That's wrong. You are no one to recommend the examiner about that place. And there are also some students who also ask the back questions to the examiner. Have you been to that place? Have you seen Amritsar? No, that is also again wrong. You are there only to answer the questions, not to ask the questions. So make sure that you answer to the question and nothing else. No extra talk, no extra questions to the examiner. So answer this question in two or three lines. I come from Amritsar, or maybe I'm from Amritsar, which is in the northern part of India. And make sure if it is possible for you to use the contraction, then always use. I don't say that I am from Amritsar is wrong. It's also correct, but try or prefer to use the contractions always when you're giving your speaking, because speaking is completely informal and you can use the contractions there. The last question is, can I see your identification or show me your identification? Now the examiner is asking for your ID. Identification means ID. That means your passport which you are carrying with you for the IELTS speaking module test. Can I see your identification or show me your identification are the questions, and how you have to answer this is, I have given the three options. You can answer in any manner according to your choice. Let's see the first one. The first one is, here you are. Suppose this is a passport in your hand and you can say, here you are. You can say, here you are, sir or ma'am. This is the first point. Second point, of course, here it is. You can say, of course, here it is. Third is be silent. The third option means no need to say anything, just simply give your passport like this. So you can use any option, no matter which option you use. All are equally important. She can use any one of it. So this was the last question. Now hope you all are clear with the things. You all are clear with what questions the examiner asks you before starting with the part one. And you all are clear how you have to face these questions, what you have to say when the examiner asks you these questions. So be prepared and all the very best to you for your IELTS speaking test. Whenever you're having your exam, always use these points and all the very best to you. And don't forget to subscribe my channel, like this video, share it with all of your friends who don't know actually about the part 0 of the speaking module. Share it, like it and comment it. Thank you so much.